Damn Adele.
Nasty. She comes across as being really nice, doesn't she? But she's selfish.
She's not thinking of other bands, particularly Fuzzbox.
No. It's all about her, isn't it?
It is all about Adele, yeah. So, welcome back, everybody. My name is Phil Marriott. Another interview today. I'm delighted to welcome a very special guest, Maggie from Fuzzbox. How you doing, Maggie?
Hey.
She's so excited. She's kicking the camera over.
Exactly, yeah.
So, Fuzzbox, a new CD. And I didn't know anything about this, even though I do follow you on Facebook and stuff. I didn't actually see anything until recently. So, reimaginings of your hits and more.
Yeah. The idea was Mike Bennett. He approached us and with the idea of like doing stuff differently, and we went along with it. With COVID, that obviously delayed things because, you know, we couldn't record. We've known Mike for quite a long time. Yeah, Mike's a lunatic. Have you ever met him?
No, I haven't. No, I can imagine though.
I don't think you can.
Tell me more. I'm very intrigued.
God, you know, I've been around rock and roll for many years. And then there's Mike Bennett.
So lockdown, I mean, I can only imagine how bad it is because it's obviously more intensified. So many of us went through, you know, really difficult times during lockdown. But as a performer, when you can't get out and you can't perform to people and you can't make music, it must have been even worse.
Well, here's the thing. I loved a lot of lockdown.
Ah.
I've got social anxiety, so people keeping away from me. It's like ruthless. And also because I'm more into the writing side, having the peace and quiet was brilliant. Secretly, I'm not big on performance. I'm very shy.
I was going to say that surprises me, but I think a lot of artists do feel like that, don't they? It's almost like, you know, creating something is one thing, but getting out on stage is quite nerve-wracking. And it's something you have to do as part of the gig, I suppose, isn't it? Part of the job.
Precisely. So you can't just sit at home creating stuff if no one's going to hear it.
So all this time then, as a performer, is it part of the job that you really dread going out? Because you must get such a high from coming off stage at the end of a gig with reception that you get as a band.
There have been points where I've nearly walked out because it's got so overwhelming. Victoria's very different. She loves performing. She hates rehearsing.
Right. But she... So this CD, tell us about the tracks, because I mean there are so many of my personal favourites. I mean Self is one of my favourites, and a lot of the really early stuff, Rules and Regulations, which I think was on BBC Six Music yesterday as well. They played it.
Yes, it was.
Yeah.
Yay.
One of the songs that you covered, Yoko Ono, Walking on Thin Ice, one of my personal favourite songs of the 80s. That seems to get forgotten about, and it shouldn't, because it's such an amazing track. And your version of it, it was a perfect tribute, I thought. It was beautifully done.
Yoko's much maligned, isn't she?
Yeah.
We did that to sort of show that actually we think she's great. You know, when you listen to her stuff, it's so experimental. And then you hear it later on other people's stuff. Her dance stuff was amazing.
Yeah. Something about that track as well, Walking on Thin Ice, it just really gives me goosebumps. There's something really haunting about it. And what you did with the cover was you added that piano on top as well, which brought that out even more. It, like, so brilliant, really, really ethereal almost. And yeah, love the video too.
That video, I always said I was going to keep that and destroy all other photos of me. And if I had children, I'd be going, that's what I look like. And it's every day.
Your proudest moment.
We all look stunning in that video.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a beautiful video, beautifully shot as well. And pop music. I love your version of pop music. So you've reimagined these tracks. So is this going to be... Because I don't think it's a complete surprise for fans. Because I think fans know that, you know, you rework songs, because you've got that really playful energy as well, so you can mix things up and it's unexpected. It's your punk ethic, I suppose, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. Like I said, COVID, we were limited in what we could do, and I think, you know, we did a very good job under trying circumstances, and I think that's why the reimagining was the easier to work with idea. We did a few days in the studio. Yeah, the rest of it was done remotely.
So have you had feedback from fans already?
Yeah, a lot of people seem to like it. That makes me happy. One of the best bits of being in a band, from my perspective, is when you get messages from people saying, oh, this song really got me through a difficult time, or, you know, really helped me to find, you know, who I am, and all of that sort of thing. And you forget that.
Yeah.
You forget it. And, or maybe it's just because I'm just not an arrogant twat, but,
yeah,
you know, so you forget that you have that impact on people's lives.
Yeah, it's true, isn't it? Because music does touch people's lives. And I think some people forget that, because it can be quite a personal thing. A lot of music resonates with people.
Oh, it gets to parts that other things can't reach. Who hasn't at one point, having suffered a heartbreak, just put the same record on repeat over and over, sobbing,
yeah,
whilst drinking loads of wine and eating chocolates, just for an example.
Yeah, I like your example. That makes me want to go and eat lots of chocolate and drink lots of wine. I might do that after this chat, actually, even though it's like 1 o'clock in the afternoon.
Not that bad.
You've driven me to it, Maggie.
I've made people do worse, Phil.
Do you feel nostalgic when you play live and you play those old songs as well as the new ones? Does it take you back to that time in the 80s? You formed in, was it 85 you formed in? Was it before,
yeah,
that? Yeah, 85. So do you think back to how it felt many years ago? It's almost like when you hear your music, like say in bars or in shops, does it make you think of things?
Not really, because it's different. You know, it's so different. Not really one for nostalgia anyway, so maybe it's different for Vix, I don't know. And like, you know, sort of living in the now is very important.
What about bands that you're listening to now? It's one band that everybody's raving about quite rightly, I think, is Wet Leg, and I love their album. Are you into them?
I like them, yeah. They're not my favourite at the moment, but I like them.
Okay, so who's your favourite, Maggie? Who are you listening to?
I don't know how you pronounce it, but I think it's Snacks, Scottish girl band. Oh, no. Cuddle! I have to look on my phone to see what... because I'm terrible with names. I can't remember the lyrics to my own songs.
Do you know what? I think a lot of artists are like that, though.
When we played Glastonbury, XXX, I just went... has been on an
in a way. Seen you live a few times. Shepherd's Bush, I think, was maybe 4 years ago, 3-4 years ago. I think it was around Christmas time.
God, that was brilliant. More than that. It's about 6 years
ago. Oh, wow, is it? Okay, yeah, time flies. 100 Club as well. Was that around about the same time?
Yeah.
Brilliant. Both brilliant shows. Because I wasn't lucky enough to see you back in the 80s. I bought all your CDs and albums, but yeah, I never saw you live in the 80s.
Oh, well, you missed out.
I know. I've seen the footage.
This is something that I can say, and I hope I don't sound arrogant, but I would have loved to have seen us if I hadn't been in us. The riot is an absolute laugh.
That was the word that I was thinking, actually. Riotous.
Yeah. Irreverence.
And fun, which is what it should be.
Absolutely. You know, we had so many laughs. Well, I was round at my friend's the other day, and she's a sound engineer. And she did our Amsterdam tour and wherever else we went. And we were going through the photos, and it all came back, you know. Victoria got so drunk one night because she was having medicinal alcohol. She was doing impersonations of planes on stage. our manager was furious, and Joe and I were egging her on, getting her more drink.
I feel like we need to do a continuing part of this video because I think there's a lot more than what you're saying. I want to delve deeper, get some gossip.
Well, you're more than welcome. One thing that I really want to say is that although we were riotous fun and everything else, do you know, I did this as part of research for an interview, and we are the only all-girl band ever to get indie number one. The only. No, you're applauding it, but it's actually disgraceful.
Yeah, well, actually it is.
At the moment, there's a surge of girl bands, and I wish I could remember some of their names, like Penis, you've got to love that. And like I said, Curzel, and there's a few others. And that's really encouraging.
So are you going to be playing more? Are you playing again? Are you in a position where you can say, you can announce dates?
Well, Vix and I are taking a break from Fuzzbox. Victoria's moving house and doing a whole load of other things. And I've got my solo... I've got my first gig on, I think it's July the 16th.
Amazing. So we can put all the details down in the show notes in the video.
Excellent.
And also for the CD.
Again, we were looking to do vinyl, but because of COVID and Adele, the mean spirited woman, buying up all the vinyl in the world.
Yeah. Damn Adele.
Nasty. She comes across as being really nice, doesn't she?
Yeah.
Not selfish.
She's not thinking of other bands, particularly Fuzzbox.
No, it's all about her, isn't it?
It is all about Adele, yeah.
Me. Yeah, so we're not doing vinyl, I think. We're just doing CD.
Because it's really tricky, isn't it? I mean, Soft Cell have had, you know, problems as well with their vinyl because of the delays. And Altered Images, again, it's taken longer than expected, their new album. So, yeah, Adele, it's all her fault. Maggie, brilliant to speak to you. Thank you so much for taking the time out to do this. And we wish you all the best with the album. Yay, go and buy it now, everyone. Put all the links down below. And we'll see you doing your solo stuff. Can't wait for that.
Yeah.
In July.
Yeah. I'll send you it when it's recorded. It's very different from Fuzzbox. I mean, very. I'm quite experimental. I mean, it's still poppy, and I've still got an obsession with space. My current favourite track is called Pluto's Heart. Pluto, on it, if you look it up on Wiki or whatever, it's got a big heart on it. You know, the Voyager CD or whatever they did?
Yeah.
They said, the disc. I'm going to put some of the stuff from that on the track as well. I'm going
to fantastic.
Weave in.
How exciting.
I'm really boring, Phil.
I don't think so. You are in Fuzzbox. You can't be boring. That's impossible.
I know. Good job I've got that.
It's so great to chat to you, Maggie. Thank you so much. And yeah, good luck with everything.
Lovely to chat to you.
See you soon.
Okay, bye.